frequently asked SQL interview questions and answers for freshers and experienced. 1. What is DBMS? A database management system. DBMS is a program that controls creation, maintenance, and use of a database. A manager that manages data in a database rather than saving it in file systems. 2. What is RDBMS? RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. RDBMS store the data into the collection of tables which is related by common fields between the columns of the table. It also provides relational operators to manipulate the data stored into the tables. Example, SQL Server. 3. What is SQL? SQL stands for Structured Query Language, and it is used to communicate with the database. This is a standard language used to perform tasks such as retrieval, updation, insertion, and deletion of data from a database. Next, what is a database? Database is nothing but an organized form of data for easy access, storing, retrieval, and managing of data. This is also known as structured form of data which can be accessed in many ways. Example, store book bank ledger entry. Next, what is alias command? Alias name can be given to a table or column. Alias name also called as false name. This alias name can be referred in where clause to identify the table or column. Example, if multiple student are present with same name, then how we use nickname to call that is the alias name. Next, what is the difference between truncate and drop statements? Truncate removes all the rows from the table and it cannot be rolled back. Drop command removes a table from the database and operation cannot be rolled back. Next, what are aggregate and scalar functions? Aggregate functions are used to evaluate mathematical calculation and return single values. This can be calculated from the columns in a table. Scalar functions return a single value based on the input value. Example, aggregate max count calculated with respect to numeric. Scalar, EUCASE, now calculated with respect to strings. Next, how can you create an empty table from an existing table? Example, select asterisk in the store book history from store book where 1 equals 2. This is a way you can copy the table structure in other table. Next, what is the best method for fetching common records from two tables? Using intersect we can get select dempit from storebook intersect select dempit from storebook history. Next 10, how to select unique records from a table. Select distinct dempit emp name from storebook. What is a cursor? A database cursor is a control which enables traversal over the rows or records in the table. This can be viewed as a pointer to one row in a set of rows. Cursor is very much useful for traversing such as retrieval, addition, and removal of database records. Next, what is a query? Query is a code written in order to get the information back from the database. Query can be designed in such a way that it matched with our expectation of the result set. Simply, a question to the database. Next, what is subquery? A subquery is a query within another query. The outer query is called as main query and inner query is called subquery. Subquery is always executed first and the result of subquery is passed on to the main query. Next, what are the types of subquery? There are two types of subquery, correlated and non-correlated. A correlated subquery cannot be considered as independent query, but it can refer the column in a table listed in the from the list of the main query. A non-correlated subquery can be considered as independent query and the output of subquery are substituted in the main query. Next, what is a stored procedure? Stored procedure is a function consists of many SQL statement to access the database system. Several SQL statements are consolidated into a stored procedure and execute them whenever and wherever required. Next, what is a trigger? Trigger is a code or programs that automatically execute with response to some event on a table or view in a database. Mainly, trigger helps to maintain the integrity of the database. Example, when a new employee is added to the storebook database, new records should be created in the related tables like salary, record book, and attendance tables. Next, what is the difference between delete and truncate commands? Delete command is used to remove rows from the table and where clause can be used for conditional set of parameters. Commit and rollback can be performed after delete statement. Truncate removes all rows from the table. Truncate operation cannot be rolled back. Next, what is a constraint? Dot. Constraint can be used to specify the limit on the data type of table. Constraint can be specified while creating or altering the table statement. Sample of constraint are, dot, not null. Check, default, unique, primary key. Foreign key, dot, next, what is data integrity? Data integrity defines the accuracy and consistency of data stored in a database. It can also define integrity constraints to enforce business rules on the data when it is entered into the application or database. Next, what is auto increment? Auto increment keyword allows the user to create a unique number to be generated when a new record is inserted into the table. Auto increment keyword can be used in Oracle and identity keyword can be used in SQL Server. Thank you for watching. We will meet in next session. Kindly subscribe to get latest video.